Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Learn Electronics. Please like and subscribe my channel. Today we are going to see one flaw that is available in a basic unstable 555 oscillator socket. That is nothing but duty cycle. So in duty cycle, T on is equal to T off plus T on. This is the duty cycle in case of this unstable 555 timer IC. In case of this 555 timer IC, the frequency is given as like f is equal to 1.44 divided by R1 plus 2R2 into C. So the charging time of the capacitor is depending upon R1 and R2. It is given like this: T1 is equal to 0.693 R1 plus R2 into C. So capacitor charges with R1 and R2, and it gives us a rise in the voltage across the capacitor. It is given like this. So you can see from this particular diagram, it charges from 1/3 VCC to 2/3 VCC. So it is depending upon the internal structure where the comparator, operational amplifier used as a comparator. So at 1/3 VCC, the first comparator becomes like off and it goes towards the 2/3 VCC where the second comparator is on, where after this the discharge happens. So discharge happened like this. So it was done like from the pin number 7. So here the 6 and 2 pin number has the same potential as like I discussed in a previous videos. You can see up in the link, there is a stable 555 timer socket. So now in this case, the T1 timing, it is given by 0.693 inside bracket R1 plus R2 into C. So capacitor is charges with R1 and R2, while T2 time, where the capacitor discharges, it depends upon only R2. So where the capacitor discharge through R2, pin number 7, towards the pin number 1, where the transistor is connected in between pin 7 and 1, and the output of the flip-flop, that is the internal structure of the circuit. So now in this case, the time T is given by T1 plus T2, so 0.693 inside bracket R1 plus 2R2 into C, that leads to a frequency 1.44 divided by R1 plus 2R2 into C. So where the duty cycle is given by R1 plus R2 divided by R1 plus 2R2, that is in a percentage form. Now in this case, you can see here the R1 and R2 both are there, while in case of discharge only R2 is there. So we can have a duty cycle, so that duty cycle is always greater than 50%, and it will leads to 100%. So when it will be 100%, when this R1 plus R2, that is exactly equal to R2, then it becomes a 100%, else it becomes a 50%. So if we need to have a duty cycle that is less than a 50%, we have to do some modification in this particular socket. So how we are going to do the modification? It is available. Now what we can do is that we cannot make the output on and its time that is shorter than off time. So you can see the on time is here and the off time is here, means T1 and T2. So we cannot make the output on time that is shorter than the off time. So why it is so? Because T1 is depending upon R1 and R2, while only T2 is depending upon R2. So the off time is greater than the on time. So if we have to make them 50%, the T1 should be equal to T2. For 50% duty cycle. For less than 50%, what we need, the T2 should be greater than T1, but it is not possible as our capacitor is charged through R1 and R2 and our capacitor is discharged through R2 only. So what about R1? So what we can do, or what about R2? So what we can do is, the solution is given in here. So the solution is like simple. We have to place a diode D2 that is like in series with the R2, but the cathode terminal is connected to R2 and anode terminal is connected to 2,6 capacitor, and the other diode is that is placed in 7 and this junction 2 and 6 and capacitors. So where this diode will be act like a switch. So how it will be? So there is a one way that we can overcome the condition where we can have less than 50% of duty cycle. So we have to connect one resistance, R2 resistance with the diode D2, and there is a diode that is called as a bypass diode that is in parallel with the R2 and D2. So what we can get in here by connecting this diode D1, so what we have, the 7 number pin is directly connected to this diode to pin number 2. Why we have this diode D2? As the capacitor is charges, it will charge through resistance R1. Here if the current try to goes over here, here is a diode D2, so it is nothing but a reverse biasing, so the path is completely closed in here. So it has the easiest path, it will go through diode D1 towards 2,6C. So what we have, the T1 time is depending upon R1 and C now. Okay, now what about T2? So T2 time is depending upon, so it will not discharge like this because this diode is in reverse bias. So it will discharge like this, it will become a forward bias R2 to pin 7. So T2 is depending upon R2 and C. So now we are very much close that R1 and R2, if they are equal, what we will have? We have a 50% of duty cycle. So now the resistance R2 is effectively shorted out by the diode. So the capacitor discharge is normal through resistance R2 only. So this is the way we can have a 50% duty cycle. So now in addition D2 diode that can be connected in series with the discharge resistor R2, if required, to ensure that the timing capacitor will only charge up through D1. So it will ensure, the diode D2 will ensure that the capacitor will only charge with D1, and this diode D1 will ensure that the capacitor is only discharged through R2 to pin number 7. So where we can say for charging, D2 is in reverse bias, and for discharging, D1 is in reverse bias. So that we can say that the T1 and T2, now if we have R1 is equal to R2, we have 50% of duty cycle. So this is the way to achieve the exact 50% of the duty cycle. So you can see from the formula what we have, a T1 is equal to 0.693 R1 plus R2 into C. While in case of what we call a charging circuit, now the R2 is absent, what we'll have now, the formula 0.693 R1 into C. So we can have from the duty cycle, so duty cycle's formula will change, it will change to R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So now what we can have, if the R1 and R2 are equal, R1 equal to R2, so it becomes a 1/2, means the 50% duty cycle will be there. If you have to make less than 50% duty cycle, what we have to do, we need that R1 need to be less than the resistor R2. So what we can have from this particular, if the R1 is less than R2, so what we can have, if the R1 is less than R2, if suppose R1 is 100 and R2 is 200, so the formula of the duty cycle, it becomes a 100 divided by 100 plus 200, so it becomes a 100 divided by 300, so it will be 1/3. So we can say it is a 33% of the duty cycle. So in this way we can achieve, by using the values of R1 and R2, the duty cycle which should be less than the 50%. So this is the way, by adding one diode in this circuit and adding the diode D2 in this circuit, just a two diode with R2 in series with D2 in a reverse bias mode, and R1 in series with D1, actually it will be connected to 2 and 6, it is in parallel with the R2 in a forward bias, which will leads to duty cycle that is less than 50% or we can have by using this particular R1 is equal to R2 a 50% exact duty cycle, where we are going to get on time and off time both will be same. So that is for the 50%. Thank you for listening my lecture. Be subscribe my channel for more and more videos on the topic of electronics. Thank you.